Darcy Lacouvet. We're here with Android Authority from CES 2013. We're here with Huawei, and they're giving us the opportunity to do a nice hands-on versus of the Droid DNA from Verizon versus the Huawei Ascend D2. So, a couple of key features. First of all, out of this bad boy, we're looking at a 3,000 milliamp battery, which is massive. Obviously, that's about 40% to 35% bigger than what's in the Droid DNA. Other than that, both devices feature 1080p displays, so really, really high pixel per inch count, 440 plus, blowing away the retina on most devices on the market. They are both 5-inch. On the rear here, we're featuring a 13 megapixel camera, which does trump the Droid DNA's 8 megapixel camera. Additionally, it is should be noted that it is a little, quite a bit thicker, but not too much that it will be a big difference. That 3,000 milliamp battery is really going to help. Other than that, we're looking at an S4 Pro on the Droid DNA with quad-core 1.5 gigahertz, whereas this one is an ARM Cortex-A9 1.5 gigahertz quad-core, so a generation behind. A little bit slower in performance, but still very fast for everyday use. So we're looking at HTC Sense skin here versus Huawei's Emotion UI. Other than that, this is also an impact, water-resistant and dust-proof device. It features Corning Gorilla Glass 2. It features 2 gigs of RAM, 32 gigabyte ROM. No mention on LTE yet, whereas this is an LTE device that probably would benefit from having a bigger battery. But both feature the same size display, obviously 1080p, like I said. Just the fact that it has such a nice large battery and is waterproof and dustproof makes it really, really attractive for us. And it has a higher megapixel count. So this is just a first hands-on look of the Huawei Ascend D2 versus the Verizon Droid DNA from HTC. My name is Darcy Lacouvet. We're here with Android Authority here at CES 2013. Thanks for checking out our videos, guys. Don't forget to subscribe.